receiving the job seeker payment will soon need to search for up to 8 jobs a month rather than 4 under changes being made by the federal government. The mutual obligation requirements, which were suspended in the early stages of COVID-19, are gradually being reintroduced. Government frontbencher Simon Birmingham has told Channel 9 the changes won't apply in Victoria.
But around the rest of the country, we're moving it slowly, steadily, back to where it was. Not jumping right back there, but just increasing that expectation for people to be out there looking for work, because we are seeing jobs being created.
Federal Health Minister Greg Hunt says the expansion of telehealth services during the pandemic has been a revolution that has kept patients and practitioners safe. The federal government has announced it will extend Medicare subsidised telehealth for GPs, nursing midwifery, allied health and mental health services until the end of March next year. Mr Hunt says the government is investing an extra $2 billion to keep the scheme and other COVID-19 health initiatives going for 6 months.
There will be support for home medicine, continued free COVID-19 pathology care, as well as further personal protective equipment for respiratory clinics, and the state and private hospital partnership agreement.
Authorities will be deploying extra resources to Melbourne's outer southeast today to combat a growing number of coronavirus cases. Leanne Wong reports.
Health authorities say they're working with local councils and community groups to tackle an outbreak in the local government area of Casey after recorded another 5 more COVID-19 cases. The cluster has now grown to 34 cases, centered mainly around the suburbs of Narre Warren and Hallam. 3 new pop-up clinics have been set up in Casey, and the health department's urging local residents to get tested. Victoria recorded another 28 coronavirus cases yesterday, the state's lowest daily increase in almost 3 months. Melbourne's 14-day average is 44.4.
And further lockdown measures have been imposed in England. The World Health Organization warns of a surge in coronavirus cases across Europe. Europe correspondent Samantha Hawley.
2 million residents in northeast England have been banned from socialising. Positive cases reached 3 times the national average. The World Health Organization says it's a trend being replicated across Europe. 50% of nations having reported a greater than 10% increase in the past 2 weeks. 7 European nations have reported a 2-fold increase in the same period. WHO says it should serve as a wake-up call. Weekly cases are now exceeding those recorded at the peak of the pandemic in March.
Air traffic controllers have been dismissed from the agency, which oversees Australian aviation, as part of a workplace crackdown on bullying and harassment. Defence correspondent Andrew Green.
In May, a report into Air Services Australia identified a culture of bullying, sexual harassment and other unacceptable behaviour. Since then, the organisation has launched more than 60 investigations into possible breaches of the staff code of conduct, and the ABC can reveal 5 employees, including air traffic controllers, have now been fired. Air Services Australia says it has a zero-tolerance approach, but insiders claim bad behaviour from senior managers, including workplace sharing of pornography, continues to be covered up.
You're listening to ABC News, and the time is 8 minutes to 8 o'clock. The director of the FBI has confirmed reports that Russia is trying to interfere in the 2020 US presidential election. US intelligence agencies found Russia acted to boost now President Donald Trump's 2016 campaign and undermine his rival Hillary Clinton. Speaking to a House of Representatives committee, FBI Director Christopher Wray says Russia is now targeting Mr. Trump's current Democratic opponent, Joe Biden.
An effort to both sow divisiveness and discord, and I think the intelligence community has assessed this publicly, primarily to denigrate Vice President Biden and what the Russians see as kind of an anti-Russian establishment.
And Mr. Ray's testimony comes after the director of America's National Counterintelligence and Security Center said Russia, China, and Iran were all trying to interfere in November's election. Supporters of Russian opposition activist Alexei Navalny say a nerve agent has been found on a water bottle in a hotel room where he stayed in the Siberian city of Tomsk. They've released a video saying it's proof that he was poisoned there and not at the airport or on a plane as previously thought. That's the BBC's Damian McGuinness reports.
The video shows Mr. Navalny's team searching the room where he'd just been staying and carefully placing empty water bottles in plastic bags. They say they had rushed to the room to find evidence when they heard that the opposition leader had just fallen ill as he was leaving.